Good to have you with us on this edition of The Last Word. Today we talk about the case that made headlines in 2017. Remember the BRD hospital tragedy in Gorakhpur in Uttar Pradesh? The tragic death of infants in Baba Raghav Das Medical College Hospital in Gorakhpur. That was the parliamentary constituency of now the Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath. Gorakhpur has been his constituency since 1998 until he became the CM. And this brought to the fore the abysmal state of public health care in Uttar Pradesh. On the night of August 11 in 2017, Dr. Kafeel Khan, viewers, a child specialist and doctor in charge of the encephalitis ward, also was said at that time, received a frantic call from the hospital informing him that all oxygen in the hospital would soon be over. Well aware that patients of encephalitis wouldn't survive without continuous oxygen supply, Dr. Khan claims that he rushed to nearby hospitals to borrow cylinders for the critical patients. He couldn't get much help. Over 60 infants died at the hospital in that period in August 2017. After this incident, the Uttar Pradesh government recommended initiating criminal action against the then principal of the BRD Medical College, Dr. Mishra, HOD of the Anesthesia Pediatric Department, Dr. Satish Kumar, and in charge of the 100-bed ward, Kafeel Khan, and the firm Pushpa Sales that was responsible for supplying oxygen. A committee was constituted, an FIR was filed, and Dr. Kafeel Khan spent 9 months in jail before he actually got bail. 2 years after the tragic incident, a departmental inquiry by the very same UP government has absolved the pediatrician Dr. Khan of the charges of medical negligence, corruption and dereliction of duty. At one point he was being called and labelled a murderer. The full blame was put on him. Today the same government has turned around and said he didn't do anything wrong. That's shock number one. Here's the worst part. This report was actually submitted to the Medical Education Department on April 18, 2019, but was not made public until now. Even Dr. Kafeel Khan wasn't told about it. Now, what does this report say? Here are the broad findings. We'll go into details in just a bit. But that Dr. Kafeel Khan isn't guilty of medical negligence was finding number one in this report. That Dr. Kafeel Khan made all efforts to control the situation on that fateful night, the first night. That Dr. Khan wasn't the nodal officer in charge of the encephalitis ward, as had been said. That he was not involved in private practice, as was alleged, as a campaign against him. That he was doing his own private practice since 2016. The report also says Dr. Khan informed his seniors about oxygen shortage. He provided seven oxygen cylinders in his personal capacity. So why did the UP government delay in acting on this report? How is Dr. Kafeel Khan going to be compensated for the pain and the trauma and harassment that he's gone through for the last 2 years? These are some of the questions I will be asking to our panel tonight. But first up, we have Kafeel Khan joining us on this show. Dr. Khan, thank you so much. Firstly, let me apologize and we're extremely sorry that you had to go through this because of the system, the way the system is broken. I can't even begin to imagine the pain and trauma that you and your family would have gone through. Dr. Kafeel Khan, can you tell us when was this report given to you? I'm given to understand that it was actually submitted. It was all done in April 2019.
The report was given on 3rd of August, and they have asked me to file the reply. I have filed the reply, and 1 month over, so I came out to the public. The thing is that why they didn't give me the report on 18th of April when the Himanshu Kumar sir submitted the report, maybe it's just Lok Sabha election was there, and they didn't want one embarrassment for the their government. Yes.
Okay, but I mean, if you're saying August, then even then, for good 4 months, the government sat on this report. If it was done in April, is that justified, Dr. Kafeel Khan?
No, ma'am, it's not 160 days. When this committee was formed by order of Yogi Adityanath ji on 22nd of August 2017, it was supposed to give the report in 90 days. But they didn't, they sat for that report for 2 years. When I moved to the Allahabad High Court, and Allahabad High Court has ordered on 7th of March 2019 to Yogi government to finish the inquiry within 90 days, then only they finishes this inquiry.
Dr. Kafeel Khan, we've highlighted some of the points, but you have the report with us. Can you actually tell us what are the key findings? What does this report say?
Yes, I'll tell you about the report. First, I will tell you when this BID auction tragedy happened on 10th of August 2017, which killed more than 70 kids because of non-payment of dues to the supplier and sudden stoppage of liquid oxygen. That time the allegation was that I was 100 was superintendent. I didn't inform my seniors about the shortage of oxygen. I was involved in corruption, and I did charges of medical negligence and about the private practice. In this report, which is submitted on 18th of April by Himanshu Kumar, Principal Secretary, Stamp and Registration, they have said this: yes, Dr. Kafeel was doing private practice, but before 8th of August 2016. I joined only on 8th of August 2016. Then he has accepted that even though Dr. Kafeel was on leave on 10th of August 2018, he tried to save every innocent life, and he brought 500 jumbo cylinder with his team to save those innocent life. There is no evidence of corruption they could find, and there is no charges of medical negligence. At the end, the inquiry officer wrote that all the charges on the charge number 3, that balhina asangat means baseless, without any substance, irrelevant. So this is the inquiry report. Still, this is a primary inquiry, and now government has to accept, and then they can revoke my suspension. But my struggle will continue until those 70 parents will be compensated. And if the Allahabad High Court is saying Dr. Kafeel is not involved in corruption, there is no charges of medical negligence, if their UP government inquiry is saying there is no medical negligence charges and he was not involved in corruption and he was not in 100 watts superintendent, then who are the real culprits? The question we should ask now, that if Dr. Kafeel is not a murderer, is not a qatil, is not an infamous, then who are the real culprits of this BID auction tragedy?
And I'll come to that in just a bit, but Dr. Kafeel, has the government been in touch with you since this report came out? Have they told you the plans, any plans about reinstating you at the BRD hospital, or when will they withdraw the case against you? You, after all, spent 9 months in jail.
I don't think so. I don't think so. Because if you remember, recently, Yogi government has celebrated the 2.5 years of their tenure, half of the of 5 years, and in that Yogi ji has himself claimed that I was roaming with welding cylinders and there was no shortage, there was no deaths because of shortage of oxygen. So they are still in denial mode, and let's see what will happen. I think the struggle is not over, and it's far from over.
Are you saying that you believe that the Yogi government may not accept or won't accept this probe report?
Maybe they'll come with some other charges, and maybe they will. I think they will haunt me again and again.
But there is a part, about the allegations that were made about your private practice, that you were holding private practice even in 2016. What about that?
No, not at all. Ma'am, in this inquiry report, he has clearly said that, yes, sir. 8-8 अगस्त के पश्चात आरोपी अधिकारी द्वारा प्राइवेट प्रैक्टिस किए जाने का कोई साक्ष्य अभिलेखों में उपलब्ध नहीं है. आई ज्वाइन बीआईडी मेडिकल कॉलेज ऑन 8th ऑफ अगस्त 2016 एज अ परमानेंट एम्प्लॉय. बिफोर दैट आई वाज अ कॉन्ट्रेक्चुअल एम्प्लॉय. आई वाज नॉट पेड नॉन पेमेंट नॉन प्रैक्टिस अलाउंसेस. सो आई वाज डूइंग प्राइवेट प्रैक्टिस. दैट इज नॉट कंसर्न्ड ऑफ योगी गवर्नमेंट. व्हेन आई ज्वाइन देम आई डिडंट डू प्राइवेट प्रैक्टिस. द क्वेश्चन इज The incident happened on 10th of August 2017 and the allegation was corruption, medical negligence and as a charge of medical superintendent. And those charges, the government himself, their inquiry report have absolved me.
It's been a long battle. It's been 2 years. I'm sure it's been a difficult time for you and your family. It's taken a toll, Dr. Kafeel. But do you think you want to continue fighting? Will you demand compensation? Will you sue the government for the trauma they have unleashed on you?
Right now, my if you ask my demand, I would surely expect that Yogi government would come in public domain and except that there was shortage of oxygen and because of non-payment of liquid oxygen, and because of that so many kids died, and government should compensate those 70 parents who lost their kids. I also demand that there should be a CBI inquiry or inquiry by a separate independent judge judiciary system and outside from the Uttar Pradesh domain. And I expect that Yogi government will accept this inquiry report and give my job back with all the due respect.
You know what happens often in these kind of big stories or tragedies is that somebody is made a scapegoat. You know, somebody who is at a slightly less powerful position, maybe more vulnerable, is picked up and the full blame is put on that. In this case, Dr. Kafeel Khan, if you are cleared of all charges, who should be held accountable? Who is responsible for what happened?
Health minister, definitely health minister and DGME. Those people who were responsible for the payment, those people who didn't act for 14 letters sent by Pushpa Sale that give my money back, otherwise we'll stop oxygen. The first letter Pushpa Sale has written on April 2017, April, May, June, July, August, he has written 14 letters, but in lieu of corruption, I think it's with some 10% commission. They didn't pay the money, and this man-made massacre, I always called it a man-made massacre, this massacre happened. Those parents, they have seen their kids dying in front of their eyes, and government was initially was in totally denial mode. They wanted to bury the whole incident. That's why, if you remember, Siddharth Nang Singh ji came up with the idea of अगस्त में तो मौतें होती रहती हैं. 2016 में 19.5 बच्चे मरे थे, 2017 में 20.5 बच्चे मरे. 20.5 लाइफ हैज नो वैल्यू फॉर देम बिकॉज ऑल द किड्स हु लॉस्ट देयर लाइफ दे वर फ्रॉम पुअर फैमिली.
Did you imagine ever on that day, did you think that this is where it will come down to on that day when you were busy saving lives? Did you think that this is what will happen? Do you now feel a burden lifting off your shoulders?
No. I never regret that, and I assure you from my heart that even if I have to get a chance again and I could save one single life, I would do it again. I agree with you that I didn't know that going to the BRD Medical College that night will haunt my whole family like that for next 2 years. And I have to go to jail. My brother was shot, and I am still suspended. So many financial responsibilities. So life was tough in 2 years, but I don't regret. I would do it again. I would do it again if I have to do.
I know it is difficult, for you to talk about that time, to describe your journey. But I just want to understand, how did your family handle all of this?
Those 9 months were jail in horrible. I still remember there was one big hall which can accommodate 60 people. There used to be 160 to 180 hardcore criminals with only one single toilet. There was no food allowed from home. My parents, they used to come to meet me once in a week. The most horrible part what I felt my life as a pediatrician, my teacher used to tell me, then you will learn your milestone when you will become a father, and your kid will gain this milestone when he will start walking, when they will start running, when they start saying papa. When this thing happened, my baby girl was 10 months old when they took me. And when I came back after 9 months, she was talking, she was running, she was climbing. She was saying papa, but she doesn't know what papa means. So that was most painful for us, for me. Those days, nobody can give me back. My whole family was tortured. There was days when even 100 rupees was a big thing for us. My mother, my wife has to merge their jewelry to fight this legal battle from lower court to high court to Supreme Court. So life is tough, and I know that being a doctor, it was not my responsibility to big cylinders, but nobody, as a common man, even if you see a kid dying in front of you, you won't allow. I did what a father and what a common a person can do. Whoever has a heart in their thorax and that the heart beats won't allow an innocent life to die in front of them.
Now that the clean sheet has come, do you think, Dr. Kafeel Khan, you'll be able to practice further, do what you actually love doing?
I'm doing free camps. I have done more than 70 camps since out of jail. I have gone to Bihar for Chamki Bimari. I was there for 15 days. I went to Assam. I went to Kerala. So we have seen more than 35,000 kids, and we have given free medication to all of them. And I'm doing one health for all campaign. We started with some health activists, non-political. I feel that BRD oxygen tragedy was just a brutal face of our broken health system. The same year which killed 70 kids in BRD Medical College, 8 lakh kids died in India. That United Nations report. This is our campaign, Health for All, I'm doing. And it says that 8 lakh kids died in 2017. 50% of children are malnourished, only 62% are immunized. The medical tourism industry has become 10 billion dollar industry. That is our budget, the 60,000 crore. India has become third largest country with people with AIDS, HIV. India has become second largest country with diabetes. 4.5 lakh people are dying because of tuberculosis. So there are so much to do in health. India is still using 1.2% of GDP. So and our whole world is using 6 to 8%. So I think I would be continue working this, and I enjoy this.
No, I think you are a hero, and many others now believe that as well. What you did then and the way you fought and what you're doing now with all of that work, wish we had some more such doctors.
Let me tell you one thing. I was not alone that night. There were 16 junior doctors were there, sisters were there, supers there were there, ward boys were there. All of them, they work for 54 hours without taking food, we work for 54 hours without taking break. It was only me, the whole team worked. Only thing that media made me hero, and then they only then made me villain. And I'm here.
And I again say, I apologize for, the pain that you may have gone through, and if there was any contribution from even the media industry. But thank you so much, Dr. Kafeel Khan. And I hope there is justice done. I hope The government apologizes and compensates for what you have gone through. And I hope the actual culprits are brought to book who are responsible for the loss of those lives that week in Gorakhpur. Thank you for joining us. Let's straight away go to our panelists joining us this evening. Atul Chandra, senior journalist. Abhishek Mishra, leader of BJP. Dr. Sameer Dalwai, spokesperson for the Indian Academy of Pediatrics. And Aniket Nikam, lawyer with the Bombay High Court. As well as Dr. Ravi Malik, CMD of Radix Hospital. Abhishek Mishra, what do you have to say tonight about what has happened? The Yogi government still can't get its story right. Sometimes they say it was lack of oxygen, then they say it wasn't lack of oxygen, it was some other problem. Then they put this blame on this one doctor, sent him to the jail for 9 months. And now you won't even accept the report.
See, Tanvi, the most shocking part is the UP government has put out a press release in which the UP government has clearly said that Vibhin Dainik Samachar Patra TV channel even social media par Dr. Kafeel Ahmed Khan, jo nirambit vyakti hai, unke doshmukt kiye jane sambandhi asatra evam bhramak prachar kiya ja raha hai. So the UP government claims that this is a false story which is run by Times of India and all the channels. Now the truth of the report is, which I have in front of me.
Yeah, I have the report in front of me
now
as well.
ADVP News, etc.
No. I have the report in front of me as well.
Let me complete
the whole report in front of me. This is the report and this is the nishkarsh, the last line of the report.
Tanvi Shukla propaganda is being exposed. Let me complete.
Ye aarop aaropi adhikari par se nahi paya jata hai.
Let me complete.
Where is the report?
Let me complete. Let me complete.
Of course.
Arey, let me complete. 1 minute. So UP government clearly says that 2013 में जब इनकी नियुक्ति हुई, तो उनके इसमें क्रमांक 3 में स्पष्ट रूप से लिखा था कि वो प्राइवेट प्रैक्टिस नहीं कर सकते थे, लेकिन 10/11/2014 को उनका नाम एक मेडी स्प्रिंग हॉस्पिटल रिसर्च सेंटर में एज अ उसमें जॉब में पाया गया, जबकि जो कि गैर कानूनी है. दिस न्यू स्टोरी दैट कफील खान इज बीन क्लियर्ड ऑफ ऑल चार्जेस इज एब्सोल्युटली फॉल्स. In 2013, he has got a job, and in 2014, in MediSpring Hospital, he was also named working in double job, private job.
Achha.
Which is an illegal act.
Is that so what led to the death of 60
said,
people?
This new story is a
I
false
don't think. Okay, 1 minute. Firstly, stop misleading my viewers and stop lying about the findings of this report. Now, answer my question. Him doing a private practice before 2016. Is that what led to the death of 70 children in 2017, Abhishek Mishra? Are you even making sense right now?
Tanvi Shukla, he had got a government job in 2013 and he was found in an official checking.
60 children, 60 infants died in August 2017. This report clearly says he was not having a private practice at that point of time. Answer my question.
No.
For the 70 deaths, for the 63 deaths in August 2017?
No.
Your propaganda, your government's lies have been exposed by your own government's reports. Sure, go ahead and prosecute him. If you believe in 2013, he was doing private practice while being on government rolls. Does that make him responsible for the 63 deaths in August 2017 in the Gorakhpur hospital? Explain to me how. Please explain to me how. I mean, the audacity to go on building lies and peddling lies is, I mean, ridiculous.
There is no clean chit. He has been caught doing private practice despite holding a government job. He has been caught red-handed.
Okay. Now, the response that I don't know if Abhishek Mishra heard, this was exactly the question that I also asked Dr. Kafeel Khan, to which he specifically said that I was appointed at BRD as per my contract on this date in 2016. At that point of time, on 8th August 2016.
He is lying.
And at that point of time, of course he is lying. Yogi government isn't. Of course he is lying. Yogi government isn't. You haven't been lying to the people of this country for 2 years. For 2 long years, you have lied to the people of this country that Dr. Kafeel Khan is responsible for these deaths. You won't now stop lying about it. The deaths happened on 10th August 2017.
Can I just come in, please?
Dr. Sameer Dalwai, go ahead, please.
Tanvi, can I just come in, please? I have a question for Mr. Mishra, if you can calmly listen to my question. My question, Mr. Mishra, is, are you interested in persecuting an individual or are you interested in what caused the death of 68 innocent children? What are you interested in? I'm asking you as a doctor, by the way. I'm a pediatrician.
I'll be honest to you. Yes, yes, I'm answering you. I'm answering responsibly.
Please
what
be honest.
Caused
if
the
you can.
Death is our prime responsibility. That is one thing separate. But Dalwaiji, somebody, a doctor who has been caught having private practices, lying on national television, trying to make himself a hero, coming on TV studios, lying. UP government has clearly said, ye bhramak dushprachar hai.
Your negligence, your negligence, your government's negligence has led to
Dalwi, I'm not done. Dalwi, listen.
Has led to deaths of little children. And for you to have the audacity to turn around and put it on one doctor is...
Dalwi, can I come in?
Go ahead, please.
Tanvi, can I just come in? Mr. Mishra, do you have any idea of what is the percentage of people in government hospitals, doctors in government hospitals who do private practice outside? Are you under the impression that this is the only one individual in the country who does private practice outside? Do you have any idea how many doctors in government hospitals do private practice? Do you have any idea? Is that such a big crime?
Dalwaiji, I have to speak on what the UP government has said. Dalwaiji, my brief is very clear. UP government has said he is guilty. He is guilty of doing private practice. He has broken the government laws.
You speak out of your conscience.
Okay, let me go across to our other panelists. Atul Chandra, senior journalist, joining us this evening. Atul Chandra, the fight and the argument about his private practice. 1 minute, please. 1 minute, please.
You're interested in pediatrics.
Atul Chandra, there are two different issues, and it seems like the UP government is trying to now cover up its lies by mixing the two issues up. Issue number one is that at the BRD hospital, in the month of August 2017, repeated requests for payments to be released to the supplier of oxygen cylinders were ignored. That the fact is that the hospital ran out of oxygen and 70 children died. That is a different aspect for which he was blamed. He was sent to jail. The second aspect is about whether or not he was conducting private practice while being on the payrolls of a government hospital. Is the government mixing the two up just to cover up?
The government is only using this private practice part to persecute Dr. Kafeel. Otherwise, his role in the inquiry report, if Mr. Abhishek Mishra reads it properly, his role on that fateful night has been lauded. He did prashansaniya karya. That is what the report says. Now, for somebody who arranged 500 cylinders, jumbo cylinders, and paid for 7 of them from his own pocket, that act of that humanitarian act, or let's say the role of a doctor which he played, that has been ignored. Private practice is such a minor issue in this state. Most of the doctors employed in government hospitals, they do private practice. They don't go to CHCs and PHCs, but they spend more time doing private practice in Lucknow. So the BJP spokesman is not familiar with the reality. But he should be answering this question. Is it such a big deal that he is doing or he was doing private practice? Even though the report says that he was doing private practice when he was working as a resident.
Correct.
Now, and at that time, apparently he was on contract.
Yes.
When he joined the hospital on a full-time basis, he stopped doing private practice.
Yes.
So, the report itself is laudatory about Dr. Kafeel's role. So,
here is what I want to highlight. Here is what I want to highlight one more time before Abhishek Mishra goes further with his propaganda. Here is what I want to highlight to our viewers. What is it that he has been given a clean chit for? He has been given a clean chit for the fact that there was dereliction of duty. He has been given clean chit for the fact that there was medical negligence. He has been not found guilty for medical negligence. The report says he made all efforts to control the situation. The report says he wasn't even the officer in charge of the encephalitis ward and that he actually wasn't involved in private practice since 2016. Now, Abhishek Mishra, you and your government can go ahead and prosecute
Chandra,
him if he was indulging in private practice and breaking the contract. Will you listen to my question first?
Tanvi,
if
can
he
I
was
please
indeed,
come in?
Indeed involved in private practice and breaking the law before 2016, by all means, go and prosecute and prove your case. My question to you tonight says the same. You and your government told us that Dr. Kafeel Khan were responsible for those deaths, that he was a murderer, that he didn't do his job, that he didn't alert the authorities about oxygen cylinders, and which is why he was sent to jail. Tell me now, admit it that you were wrong and that you lied to us.
Can I reply to Mr. Chandra, please? Mr. Chandra ji,
reply to my question first.
Just two lines, sun lijiye. Nahi, I will reply to Mr. Chandra first. He has asked me a question, I'll reply to him.
Okay.
Dr. Chandra ji, aapke liye. First, kaha jata hai ki Dr. Kafeel ye batane mein asamarth rahe ki 23 mai 2013 ko jab unka niyukti aadesh nikla, to usme spasht tha ki wo private job nahi kar sakte, private practice nahi kar sakte. Parantu Medi Spring Hospital mein wo paaye gaye karte hue. So in 2013, he was niyukti mein unka spasht tha. Ye contract, one track, Kafeel Khan ka jhoot hai. Pehli baat. 2013,
23 mai ko unko job lag chuka tha. Agar aap padh karke bolenge,
toh hume
padh I will also have to go through that report. I also have a copy of that report.
Can I come in?
Yes. Okay. One minute, please. I have two other panelists who have not spoken. I just want to highlight this fact that every single time I ask Abhishek Mishra about the negligence, about those responsible for the death of those children, he has nothing to say. He's obsessed over one point about private practice. As a representative of BJP, he has nothing to tell me about who was accountable for those children who died if Kafeel Khan isn't. Aniket Nikam, to you first, and Dr. Malik, I'm coming to you after that for sure. Aniket Nikam, go ahead, please.
Tanvi, first we need to identify what was the cause of incident. Now, everybody knows that the cause of incident was shortage and stoppage of that of oxygen that was being provided to the hospital. Now, it was brought to your notice of everyone that the concerned supplier had written letters after letters to several authorities informing that the dues are due and please clear them or else the oxygen will be stopped. Now, they were aware that this is leading to an eventuality. Now, instead of taking cognizance to it, they turned Nelson's eye to it and they allowed this incident to happen. Now, after knowing that this was the real reason, causa causans, for the cause of this incident, instead of investigating this angle, I fail to understand why Dr. Khan was shown as accused number one. Having said that and having considered the fact that he's been given a clean chit in a disciplinary inquiry, I must also tell you, because I'm a student of law, I practice law, that the standard of proof in a disciplinary inquiry and standard of proof in a criminal trial is different. In disciplinary inquiry, it is preponderance of probabilities. In a criminal trial, it is beyond shadow of doubt. Now, when the disciplinary inquiry committee report categorically holds that he is not responsible, he has not committed any criminal negligence. Now it is for the investigating officer to take this aspect into consideration and to see whether really any offence against Mr. Khan is made out or not, and whether to also consider dropping charges of 302 against him or whichever charges are being invoked against him.
Okay, I take your point, but look at what has happened here. They sat on this report, they wouldn't submit this report, they wouldn't close it, they wouldn't finish it until the court stepped in. The report was then given to the government in April 2019. It was only handed over and sent to Kafeel Khan in August seeking his response. The government is yet to take a decision on whether they accept the report or not accept the report. Now, what does that show? That shows that the government is not interested in finding out whether it was Dr. Kafeel Khan or somebody else who was responsible, what was the cause, and how can you fix it? Dr. Malik, go ahead, please. You wanted to come in.
Mr. Abhishek Mishra is diverting the issue for whatever reasons best known to him. I have four questions for him. Number one, why was Mr. Khan sent to jail? Was it because of he was doing a private practice along with the government job or for some other reasons? Number one, what was the reason why he was sent to jail and why he has gone through so much of humiliation? Number one. Number two, Now, since he has been exonerated, who is the person responsible for this massacre of 65 children? Who is to go to jail? Number three, what was your government doing from 2013 to 2016? When Mr. Khan was, as told by you, when Mr. Khan was doing practice on daily basis, what was the government doing there? And number four, why are you diverting the issue? Right now, we are discussing, you hang Dr. Khan for doing private practice. That is a separate issue. But right now, the issue is why he was sent to jail. And I must tell you, there are two types of lapses. One is the administrative lapse and one is the lapse on the part of the clinician. If you are not treating the patient properly, you are not diagnosing, then it comes as a medical negligence. I must tell you, Dr. Kafeel Khan is a clinician. He is not an administrative officer. He has no business to, he is not authorized to pay to the Pushpa or whatever oxygen agencies. He is not given the administrative power to deal with the oxygen or the supply of the medicines or the supply or taking care of the infrastructure. So it is better we don't divert the issue, Mr. Mishra, and please answer these four questions.
Okay. Yes, Mr. Abhishek Mishra, go ahead.
Yes.
Tanvi, can I just come in for a minute?
I'm not diverting the issue. Today, the topic of discussion is whether what Tanvi is claiming is that he has been given clean chit. Only my job representing BJP is when the UP government clearly said he has not been given clean
chit. This report only says
held guilty
there is no evidence against him that he is responsible of criminal negligence and dereliction of duty that led to deaths of those children. This report is saying it, Abhishek Mishra. Aapne shayad padha nahi. Aapne aise Google karke control F search dabaya wo document mein private practice dhunda and phir private practice wala part padhte aa gaya. Aapne आपने dereliction of duty, criminal negligence, failure to inform the seniors, whether or not he was actually responsible, you have not read any of those parts. Abhishek Mishra,
he has broken the law. Don't defend him, Tanvi Shukla. He has broken the law.
Okay, now explain to me, by him breaking the law, by doing private practice in 2013 and 2014, how did that lead to deaths of 63 children? In 2017 August.
So, Tanvi, the unfortunate death that the investigation report that will be told subsequently by the UP Health Ministry.
Okay.
I do not have the report. I am not the UP Health Ministry.
That's what I'm saying.
I cannot, in my capacity, answer the exact cause of deaths.
Somebody only gave you only one page of the report.
I have come here today to expose Mr. Kafeel Khan and
the lies
which the UP government has said that they are lying on television and he has been doing clean chit.
Unko clean chit nahi mila hai. Dekh lijiye, bahut sare pages hai isme alag alag allegations ke, alag alag findings hai ki ye aarop sidh hua ki nahi hua, ye aarop sidh hua ki nahi hua. Har ek aarop ki detail mein wo gaye hain. Private practice kar rahe the, inhone kya kaha, unhone kya kaha, wo sab hai isme.
Ye Brahman prachar
hai. You only done control F and searched only for private practice and not read rest of the report, then that's not really my problem. Please read the entire report. I have a caller on the phone line who's actually also a doctor, I believe, from Gorakhpur, Dr. Ashok Prasad. Dr. Ashok Prasad, I'm told you wanted to make a point about the private practice angle. Go ahead.
Sure, Mr. Shukla. Well, I'd like to have a writer over here. For years, I've been noticing people being put up by different political parties to battle lies. But even by those standards, this standard of mendacity coming from Abhishek Mishra disgusts me. If he was ever to visit Gorakhpur and see that, he would have to suspend about 3/4 of the medical college over here. They are all indulging in private practice, and many of them are extremely close to the present government. He should know that. If he doesn't know that, then he doesn't deserve to be on your panel.
Okay, I'm glad Dr. Ashok Prasad that you actually called and said this, because this is definitely something that must also be looked at if 3/4 of the doctors in all of these medical colleges are indulging in private practice. Yes, Dr. Dalwai, go ahead, please.
Tanvi,
yeah, so
just...
I'd
like to say...
Yes, Mr. Chandra, to you next.
Academy of Pediatrics. Mm. And Mr. Mishra, please keep quiet. You're talking rubbish. You have done worse than what the matter was. You have put UP government in the worst light by your comments and your passion about hating doctors. It's people like you who instigate mobs into hospitals.
It's people like you who bring mobs into hospitals, politicians and goons like you, who bring people in to hit doctors. And after what Dr. Malik has said, there is no need for this debate. He just nailed it. And this doesn't happen only in this hospital. In all government hospitals, it's the administration, for the sake of corruption, does all this malpractice. And the clinicians, as he said very rightly, have to suffer. The clinician has no role in ordering, in tendering. He has to deal with sub-quality equipment in the hospital. And in spite of that, they try their best to save lives. And yet when something goes wrong, guess whom the administration puts in front of the mob? It's the doctor who gets beaten up everywhere. In all the government hospitals, in spite of working 2 days, 3 days, without food, without bath. And it's because of goons like this fellow. You've done worse today. It's better the UP government had not sent you today, because you have performed worse than the government report.
No, but you know,
you have no passion.
Firstly, let's not make comments, personal comments about any of the panelists.
Thank you very much.
Yes, but Dr. Dalwai, I think we also need to understand that this is exactly the stand that the UP government is going to take. 1 minute, gentlemen. 1 minute. Take everybody, take a deep breath here. Let me just point out to our viewers. Firstly, I don't want any personal comments against any of my panelists, even whether it's a political representative or a citizen representative. No personal comments, firstly. Secondly, I think this is going to be the Yogi government's official stand, that this is not the report that has to be accepted. Okay, Abhishek Mishra has obviously not gotten any more answers for us. He has chosen to not take any more of our questions and walk off. That's the BJP representative for you, Abhishek Mishra, walking out of there. But I can understand his position. He has nothing else to offer to us. The report says it all. Clean shit to the doctor who was sent to jail for 9 months and zero evidence found. Aniket Nikam, you wanted to make a point. Before I let you go, go ahead, please finish that point, and then I have to go to Atul Chandra.
Tanvi, yes. Tanvi, it's very basic. They are only saying that because he was involved in private practice, that is why he's responsible. Now, why are they forgetting the fact that even if it is presumed for a moment that he was involved in private practice, on that unfortunate day, he was not elsewhere. He was in that hospital serving those children, trying to save them. So it is not as if he had given it a miss because he wanted to attend some private client. He was there in the hospital. So I don't understand this argument of theirs that since he is involved in private practice, therefore he is responsible for the death of these many children. The only reason why this incident has occurred because of the negligence of the hospital in not clearing their payments. And this something is not for which he could be held responsible.
Yes, Mr. Atul Chandra, go ahead, please.
No, my point that which I was trying to make before this spokesman left, how many medical college doctors have been arrested for doing private practice? Does it form part of a cognizable offense? I don't think so. Then, if it does not form part of cognizable offenses, how come Dr. Kafeel Khan has been charged under various sections of IPC?
Correct.
Those particular charges related to children's death and lack of oxygen, which the government was denying permanently for a very long time. Now that this has been proved that there was oxygen shortage, the government is not going to act against anyone and keep harassing Dr. Kafeel Khan, because those involved in non-payment of the gas company's dues are high officials and ministers. And nobody can touch them easily for various reasons. And he's the scapegoat which they found they could do anything with him.
You know, here is the point, and I want to remind this to our viewers. We spoke about it earlier as well. There were about 30 letters allegedly written to the authorities at the BRD Medical College, and the government, and this is the essential part, the UP government, alerting them to the fact that the budget had not been cleared for months and that pending payments to the oxygen supplier had mounted to 63 lakh rupees. Now, Dr. Malik, that is a problem with our public healthcare system. And like you're pointing out, the scapegoat was the doctor who's, you know, on duty doing his job, and not the government officials, the health department officials, who are supposed to ensure that these kind of problems don't occur.
My matter of concern is that since a doctor is a vulnerable and a soft target, he was just being used as a scapegoat and sent to jail. Imagine what happens to a clinician who is put to jail for 9 months with the hardened criminals and with no fault of his own. And now the government is coming with a defense that, you know, basically he has been sent to the jail because he was practicing. Now, from where was the government from 2013 to 2016 when he was practicing? And this incident occurred in year 2017. So it is very important that the basically it is the negligence on the part of the people that they have taken the clinician as a scapegoat. Moreover, why they have not paid the amount to the oxygen supplier? 63 lakhs is a huge amount. And especially under the backdrop of fact that 13 letters and 13 reminders has been sent by that supplier to the hospital that kindly release my fund. Otherwise, I am going to take away the supply of oxygen. So it is a big negligence at the part of the administration. Now, what the UP government is taking the action against the administrators who have not paid at the right time. And I must tell you that our clinician, Dr. Khan, has arranged 7 cylinders out of his own pocket and resources to save those children, and he has been sent to jail. It is a very, very bad precedence. Every good clinician will not like to work in government setups because of this if they are being used as a scapegoat and sent to jail. So it is, I must congratulate Mirror Now for taking up this issue. This is a very, very important issue, and we should follow up with that, and we should see to it that Dr. Khan is not in any way more harassed in future also. And we all clinicians are with him. It is an indefensible situation that if he was not allowed to do private practice, he should have not done it. Hang him for that. Whatever law is there, take care of him. But there is no question that you will harass the doctors for the administrative failure. And it is a high time that we should now wake up and see the facilities in the government hospital so that these kind of negligent deaths. Imagine what has happened to every child's family. There were more than 60 deaths.
Yes.
See how much their parents, their aunts, their uncles, they must have gone through the agony.
And his family, the agony that his family has gone through. And he was speaking to us just a short while ago. In those 9 months, he couldn't see the face of his newborn daughter.
And yes. The family of the poor doctor.
Absolutely. They had to literally mortgage their jewelry to be able to pay the legal costs for this battle. And why does he have to fight this battle?
The government should apologize to this doctor.
The government is still out to get him. The government is still painting him as the demon here. The government is still trying to find other ways to prosecute him and send him behind bars while covering up on the actual issue. Fair enough. If somebody's broken the law, indulged in private practice when they shouldn't be, that's a different matter altogether. That doesn't explain what happened at the BRD Gorakhpur Hospital in August 2017. That doesn't explain the larger problem that we have in our government hospitals of underpaid and overworked doctors who are then blamed for everything and then have to even face the wrath of the relatives of the families often. That's the reality. And that is what the government needs to be focusing on. But that's not what they're doing. I want to just, yes, Dr. Dalwai, I'm coming to you in just 30 seconds. Let me also highlight how the government attempted to delay this old report because they knew there was no evidence against him. On 22nd August 2017, the committee was formed. They were supposed to give this report in 90 days. 2017, August, over 2 years ago. On 7th March 2019, the Allahabad High Court ordered the government to finish the report then in 90 days. So on 18th April, the report was submitted by the investigating officer and it was only sent to Dr. Kafeel Khan on 3rd of August 2019. What does that say about the intent of the Yogi government? I have a caller on the phone line, Mr. C.S. Gupta, on the phone line from Delhi. Good evening. Go ahead, please.
Good evening, Tanviji. Thank you for having me online. My point is very simple, and that in our country, all these, you know, investigation and interrogation takes decades to resolve. By that time, the victims don't get compensation.
Yes.
So, main ye janna chahta hu ki hospital ka situation, I agree with the doctors in the panel. I completely disagree with this gentleman, whatever his name may be, kya Mishra ya kya naam hai iska. He's trying to completely distract attention away from the main focus. Ki bachche mar gaye hain, doctors bhi pareshan hain. Apne system ko sudhara hai ki nahi sudhara hai. और आज के डेट में अभी स्टेटस क्या है उनको बोलिए पता करने के लिए कि स्टेटस क्या है, फिर आपके शो में वो बैठे। नंबर टू, मैं आपको एक बताना चाह रहा था कि मैं कहीं बैठा हुआ था, कुछ वकील वहां पे थे। डू यू रिमेम्बर व्हेन भोपाल गैस ट्रेजेडी हैपेंड?
यस,
इट वाज डिकेड्स बैक। तो उनका कुछ वो विक्टिम्स की तरफ से वो जा रहे थे, तो उनका ये डिस्कशन था कि भोपाल गैस ट्रेजेडी में विक्टिम्स को कंपनसेशन नहीं मिलेगा क्योंकि अब तो वो मर गए हैं, उनके लिए कौन लड़ेगा। This is decades ago. आज भी भोपाल गैस ट्रेजेडी का
Absolutely, Mr. Gupta, आज भी चल रहा है और ऐसे बहुत सारे केसेस हैं where often promises are made, announced and no compensation is given. Today, Dr. Kafeel Khan, when he was speaking to us about this report, one of his main demands was compensation to the families of those 60 infants. He is still thinking about that. And he's still making that demand for compensation to those families and of course to ensure that such kinds of instances don't happen again. I think it is shameful that the Yogi government still won't admit that they got the wrong man. I think it is shameful that the Yogi government is in denial, doesn't want to look into the real issue. If you don't do that, how will you fix the real problem? How will you ensure that we don't lose such lives because of criminal negligence or bureaucratic apathy again? It's easy to pick up somebody who's not influential, who's vulnerable, and put the blame on them and make them a scapegoat. But your job actually is to fix the real problem and save those lives. So I'm sure Dr. Kafeel Khan, when he said that the government is not going to accept this report, knew what's coming his way. Another battle? Now it depends on us whether we are going to stand by him and demand justice, not just for him, but actually for the families of those 60 infants. Thank you so much for joining us on this debate.